How's it going, everybody? It is Josh Thomas here, and today we are going to be opening up the latest Nick box. I'm pretty sure the theme this month is treasure. There's a little bit of a hint, the fact that it comes in a treasure box. Look at this box! It is amazing. Got all sorts of little Nicktoons peeking out the cracks of the wood here. As usual, the box is really neat in its unique little design. So what kind of treasures lie inside here? We're gonna find out. Thankfully, this is a fake lock. We don't have to actually use a key to open it. But this is a big box. Look at this. Compared to the size of my head. Look at that. This is about the size of four of my heads. Okay, let's open it up. As usual, I am not going to look at everything at once. We're just gonna open her up and see what's inside. Okay, this feels like it could be... Alright, so it's weird. This is the one thing that I knew was in here. This is a cat dog figure. It's a vinyl figure. Really neat boxing. Look at that. Some new artwork there. Oh, man. I like cat dog, but it was... I haven't seen, like, every episode of the show. But yeah, I think this is the one thing I spoiled for myself, because I'm pretty sure on social media they posted it. I think it was, like, Instagram or it was Facebook. But let's see what the quality is like. So we've got to put them on the stand here. As usual, everything in the Nick box is exclusive to the Nick box. You can't get it anywhere else. This should be locking in there. Why is it not? There we go. I guess I had to use some manly brute force to get it in. But there you go. That is cat dog looking extremely pleased with themselves. What a weird show. Just looking at this figure makes me realize how strange it is that there's a cat and dog. But that's a cool figure. I like it. All right. Let's move on. So I probably should grab, there's always a shirt. By the way, I'm wearing my Reptar shirt, but every time I put on a Nickelodeon shirt before doing this unboxing thing, there's always a shirt inside that I have to change into. So I think this is a shirt. It feels like a shirt. So let's see what it is. It is a shirt. What is, oh! So this is an Are You Afraid of the Dark themed shirt for the Midnight Society. This is actually, this smells weird. It smells like lemon. Why does this smell like Lemon Pledge? I don't know, but okay. Maybe that's what the Midnight Society smelt like. We never knew, and now we finally do. But this is a perfect shirt for October. So I think I'm going to have to change into this right now. Let's do it. I should point out that on the back of the shirt, it says, Are You Afraid of the Dark? All right. I smell like Lemon Pledge, and I look like an official member of the Midnight Society. This is a cool shirt. I like that it's kind of slightly discreet. You know, it's not like a giant logo or something for the show. It's like a, you know, people who, you'd have to be in the know to totally get it. So it's kind of cool. This seems like it's in a box of some sort. What is it? Oh my gosh! Look at this. So this is a Reptar bar. I don't know. Oh, it might be food. I was going to say, I don't know if this will be food, but there is an expiration date on it. It's a little bit open. Oh no, this isn't. I think the expiration date is just for novelty purposes. Because as I look at this Velcro to open it up, but as I open it up, it is a little, that is pretty amazing. It is a plushie of a Reptar bar, and you can even see the like green fondant inside of it. I don't know what's inside of a Reptar bar. This smells like Lemon Pledge too. I'm starting to get convinced that the Nick box is made in a factory that also makes Lemon Pledge. But this is a neat novelty toy. I like it. Does it squeak? No, of course it doesn't squeak. Why did I think it would squeak? I don't know. I just like things that squeak. I probably should give you guys a little bit more of a look at the box. The box obviously is made to look like the candy wrapper. Reptar bar. I actually just recently downloaded on Amazon Video the Halloween episode where these premiered on Rugrats, and I've been watching it. So I'm gonna have to snuggle up to my Reptar bar when I watch it next. Why would you snuggle a Reptar bar? I don't know. Let's grab some more booty. I love grabbing booty. Oh, this feels like it might be several things that go together. I don't know if I got them all. Let's see. Oh, that's gonna spoil it. That's the thing. Oh, look, it's a little treasure map. Look at that. All right. But that shows you what's inside. We don't want to know that yet. So this is... this is an Ariel Monsters air freshener. What is the scent? I don't know. Maybe lemon. Oh, wait, wait. That's why this smells. That's why the whole box smells. It smells like this, which I think is like a lemony scent. Oh man, mystery solved. Okay. So yeah, I mean, that's not exactly the most amazing thing ever. It's an air freshener, but I'm sure it's just like a little extra bonusy thing. Goes with the month, obviously. You know what's weird about Ah Real Monsters? People pronounce it like I just did there, Ah Real Monsters, which is like the least enthusiastic way to pronounce the name, because it's like A-H-H-H-H, exclamation mark, exclamation mark, exclamation mark. So I think you're supposed to scream the name of this, like, Ah Real Monster. I don't know. It's just something I noticed. It's a weird show to say because nobody says it with enthusiasm. So there's definitely a little bit of a Halloween theme going on here. We've gotten 1, 2, 3, 4 with the Reptar Bar. So there's like been 4 Halloween themed things. I'm kind of happy about that. I thought it would just kind of be a generic theme, but they have gone Halloween here. This is a candy dish of crumb. I am incredibly excited about that. How are they gonna handle his eyes? I guess he would just be holding them. There's some really weird designs in this show. I always loved this growing up. I loved most Nicktoons, but this one in particular, since I'm obsessed with Halloween, this one really was a fave of mine. Let's see what this candy dish looks like. That is incredible. It is ceramic. It's made out of like a glass. I don't know how much, you'd have to put little candies in there because it's kind of small, but that is really neat. I love that. I'm going to display this actually for Halloween. This is a really weird shape. It's heavy. Oh my gosh. It's a Nick Box plate set. What? Okay, we've got the Angry Beavers, Ren and Stimpy, Hey Arnold, and Rugrats. There's the logos around the back. We gotta open these up. This feels somewhat heavy. I don't have any fingernails, which is probably gonna make this somewhat difficult. There we go. Let's see what these look like. So, of course, we've already seen it, but there is the Angry Beavers. Great show. We got Hey Arnold. Another great show. Oh, there's even like fall decorations up in the classroom there. Rugrats. Nice. And then finally, Ren and Stimpy. So those are amazing. They're plastic, but they're like a decent quality plastic. Look at those babies. Oh, this is a weird shape. This feels weird too. Is this some sort of a book or a binder? Let's find out. Oh my gosh, it is. What? What? Oh, this is amazing. Look at this. It's the, I can't remember. Oh, it's got a zipper on it. It's from Ah Real Monsters, obviously. But wasn't there, I'm recognizing it. My brain is recognizing this, but I don't remember what it was in the show. Is there some sort of like monster book of scares or something? Where's the zipper? Let's open it up. It's probably just going to have like notepaper inside, I'd imagine. Oh no, it's like an actual binder. You can keep stuff in, your phone, your pencils. Your whatever, it's like a good thing to use for school. I've not been in school for a long time, but that is amazing. Oh my God, now I want to remember what this was in the show. I think the teacher had like a big book that he would open up. And I remember the teacher wore high heels, 4 of them, which was weird. But this is like, it's not real leather, I'd imagine, but it's like a fake leather and everything. That's pretty high quality and amazing. Wow. This has been a pretty good box so far, as far as quality content goes. Except for this, which is obviously pretty cheap, but kind of neat nonetheless. It is a wall clock for Rocko's Modern Life. I'm fairly certain this is the clock that punches him at the beginning of the intro. That's kind of amazing. Oh, we got some good artwork there of Rocko just all smashed. What is Spunky doing? Spunky is just rolling around. That's kind of crazy. I guess you can mount it on a wall in the back. You can see there. It's a neat little clock. I like the crazy novelty of that. I am so excited about the new kind of reboot of Rocko's Modern Life. They're doing like the TV special. They showed the preview on YouTube like a couple months ago. Well, actually it was in the summer. But it looks so good. I would love for Nickelodeon to just start a new season of Rocko's Modern Life. Maybe they will. If that's insanely successful, and it looks like it will be, we could be looking at like more Rocko episodes, which would be incredible. But this is a neat little item. I think we are kind of down to the last thing. I don't know what this could be. Actually, I think I do. It feels like a book of matches, which I don't know if they would give you that, because kids. But it is, actually. Well, oh, no. It's not a book of matches. It's kind of like a book of matches. It even has a thing you could strike. I was like, why would they give kids a book of matches, but it's for the Midnight Society, and it is an enamel pin that says official member of the Midnight Society. I don't think it's gonna focus. Will it focus now if I put it in front of my head? Okay, I can't get it to focus, but just trust me, that's what it says. Okay, so that is everything in this month's Nick Box. The inside is actually really neat. I should show you that. Look at that! Just all those Nicktoons hanging out. in that cool purple background there. So yeah, this is the, I believe, this is the fifth Nick box. I've gotten them all. I grew up in the 90s, so naturally the concept of the Nick box is absolutely amazing to me. So yeah, I've liked this box. Overall, I'd give this an A, absolutely. This seemed like it was one of the thicker Nick boxes, like I said before. A lot of thick booty in this treasure chest, just the way I like it. I'll talk to you guys later on. Bye-bye.